We have a new cases. Here we have the AD doctor in the thumb is very, very weak. We test the opponents, the DDT minimi. This is weak. If I test the flexor carpi ulnaris, this is really weak. Yes? We have many muscles associated with the ulnar nerve. Could be compression on the joint. Could be compression at the level of the elbow. Could be compression above the shoulder or in the neck. When we have a problem in the elbow, very often when we have a weak or hypertonic extensors, in this case the anconius, this is strong. Sorry. Push. This is a strong paralysis, and this is weak now. We were looking to find a place that improved the muscle in the hand, the muscle of the ulnar nerve. One of them could be behind the clavicle, or can be behind the pectoralis minor. But the pectoralis minor, we use the alternative test, is strong. And inhibits. If I continue to look for something, I'm going to test now the scalene muscles. Can you help me? Put your hand there. Push. We are going now to ask him to put the hand, the head against the hand, to inhibit the scalene muscles. And with this one, we are going to decrease the hypertonicity and see if improves the strength of the muscles associated with the ulnar nerve. Hold it. Now, the doctor is really, really strong. If I test the opponent, now it's much more strong, normal. If I test the flexor carpi ulnaris, really, really strong. If I test him with paralysis lines, inhibits very well. Means it's a nerve compression at the level of the scalene muscles. Thank you. Now, one option or problem with the scalene muscles and compression can be pelvic category number one. Yep. Then again, this is going to be weak. This is going to be weak. But if he TL the right side, the right SI joint, now again becoming strong. Again, it's strong. Got it? Then we have a nerve compression at the level of the scalene muscles caused by pelvic category number one. In this case, pelvic category number one is non-priority. After we test for priority, triple stim, and then check what stimulus negate the test, we found that the spinotectal visual was the primary. And spinotectal auditory was the main secondary. Then, if I test again, straight there.
Yeah.
No, not the other. Hold on. No, there it is. Now this is weak. He tried to bend the hand to use other muscles, but he extend the hand. Now it's very, very weak. If I make a sound around the SI joint and DTR, now it's basic both. Now again becoming strong. Again, push, push, push harder, strong, and this one is strong. Got it? But if I make a sound near the same joint, again, weakens. Yep. This is the a pathology, or this is a dysfunction of the spinotectal that cause pelvic category number one, that cause hypertonicity of the skeletal muscles. We bend the neck, extending the head a little bit to avoid the SCM to help the skeletal muscles, because with a little extension, now SCM becomes an extensor and not a flexor. This test is strong, fire lines, and it's hypertonic. If I again make a sound, and DTR, back, now inhibit very well. Then the treatment for this condition is to look at the SI joint, make a sound, and DTR. We found the in the area, SI joint, both the spinotectal visual and spinotectal auditory. Then looking there, sound, and DTR, fix the problem. Questions? Any question? This is a nice case because we have many conditions that ends with the nerve compression. Ulnar nerve weak, or muscle, or ulnar nerve muscles weak, just because he has a spinotectal in the SI joint.